On behalf of the CrossBoss First trial investigators, it is my privilege to present the primary results of the CrossBoss First randomized control trial. These are my disclosures, and this is a full list of the investigators of the trial. There is currently controversy regarding the optimal initial crossing strategy in the antegrade direction. The hybrid algorithm preferentially uses the antegrade dissection re-entry for crossing long lesions, those that are more than 20 millimeters long, whereas in the Asia-Pacific algorithm, there's preference in using parallel wiring. The CrossBoss catheter is a metallic catheter with a 1 millimeter distal atraumatic tip that is advanced by using the fast spin technique. Once advanced, there are different possibilities. One is that it enters a side branch. The other is that it goes partially inside the occlusion. It can cross, in some cases, from proximal to true distal true lumen. And in some other cases, it goes subintimal, requiring use of the stingray system for re-entry. We designed the CrossBoss First trial to compare upfront use of the CrossBoss catheter versus antegrade wire escalation for antegrade crossing of coronary CTOs. The study was done at 11 US centers that were all experienced in doing CTO intervention. A total of 246 patients were enrolled, and the study was funded by Boston Scientific. The study included 246 patients. The inclusion criteria was a planned antegrade crossing attempt, no plan for primary retrograde approach, and no ostial lesions within 5 millimeters of the vessel ostium. Patients were randomized 1-to-1 to CrossBoss or wire escalation, and the primary endpoint was crossing time, since those experienced centers are known to achieve high success rates, whereas the primary safety endpoint was the incidence of periprocedural adverse events. Assuming a crossing time of 66 minutes in the guide wire group and a 30% relative reduction in the CrossBoss group, a total of 246 patients were needed to have 80% power for the primary endpoint. Out of 966 patients who were screened, 280 met the eligibility criteria, and of those, 246 were enrolled and randomized. 122 were randomized to the CrossBoss group and 124 to the guide wire group, and there were no losses to follow up since the study only included in-hospital follow-up. This is the list of the study centers. They were all highly experienced centers in CTO intervention. The top three enrollers were Dr. Halligan, Dr. Nicholson, and Dr. Speedy. The two study groups were well balanced in terms of baseline characteristics. Mean age was 65 years, and almost 40% of the patients had diabetes. Previous bypass was done in approximately a quarter of the study patients. Baseline creatinine was 1. As is seen in most contemporary CTO series, the majority of CTO target lesions were right coronary artery CTOs in almost 2/3 of the lesions, followed by LAD and circumflex CTOs. Calcification was present in 42-46% of patients, and moderate or severe proximal tortuosity was present in approximately a quarter of the study patients. About 15% had proximal cap ambiguity. 23% of the lesions were due to in-stent restenosis. The proximal vessel diameter was 2.6 millimeters. JACC score was 2, and the progress CTO score was 0.91 to 0.95. The technical success was high and was similar in both arms of the study at approximately 88%. In terms of the initial crossing strategy, it was wires in the guide wire group. In some of the patients in the CrossBoss group, a wire was advanced through the CrossBoss catheter, whereas the final successful crossing strategy was 50% wire escalation in the guide wire group versus 50% dissection re-entry in the CrossBoss group, with the retrograde approach being used in approximately 17-18% of patients in both groups. The primary study endpoint, the crossing time, was 56 minutes in the CrossBoss group versus 66 minutes in the guide wire group, a difference that was not statistically significant. The standardized mean difference was 0.094, suggesting that the difference was small. There was no significant difference in the incidence of periprocedural major adverse cardiac events, 4% in the guidewire group versus 3% in the crossbows group. In a post hoc analysis, patients who had in-stent restenosis had a faster crossing time with the crossbows. It was 41 minutes versus 66 minutes with antegrade wire escalation with a p-value of 0.046. There were 0% complications in the crossbows first group, in this subgroup, versus 4% with the guidewire group. Procedural success was similar in both groups. The total procedure time was 109 minutes in both groups. There were no difference in fluoroscopy time, air camera radiation dose, contrast volume, total fluoroscopy time, and air camera radiation dose at crossing. Procedural MACE was 4% in the guidewire group and 3% in the crossbows group. There was actually a significant trend for less perforations in the crossbows group as compared with the guidewire group with a p-value of 0.06. Equipment utilization was similar in the two groups with similar number of stents, balloons, microcatheters, and guide wires. And equipment costs were also similar. The overall cost was a little above 5,000, and it was similar in both study groups. The crossbows group, as expected, had higher costs for use of crossbows and Stingray, whereas the antegrade wire escalation group had higher cost for microcatheters. The study has limitations. First, it was done in centers that are highly experienced in CTO intervention. Therefore, the results may not necessarily apply to less experienced centers. As described previously, in 22% of patients that were randomized to the crossbows group, the crossing was achieved by advancing a guide wire through the crossbows catheter. In a few cases in both groups, the initially selected strategy was not used, and that was due to repeat angiographic assessment with dual injection at the time of the procedure. And finally, the study is subject to both type 1 and 2 error, and it was not powered for the primary safety endpoint. So in summary, as compared with the primary wire escalation strategy, crossbows first shows that upfront use of the crossbows catheter was associated with similar crossing time, similar success and procedural MACE rates, and similar equipment utilization and costs. And there are further studies needed to determine whether some subgroups, such as the in-stent restenotic CTOs, are better suited for crossing with a crossbows catheter. In my opinion, the practical implications of the study are that for non-in-stent restenosing CTOs, either strategy, using a crossbows catheter or using wire escalation, has similar success, efficiency, and cost. It does appear that the crossbows first may give better results for in-stent restenotic CTOs, but antegrade dissection reentry remains an important strategy for CTO PCI in general, because even in the antegrade wire escalation group, the use of antegrade dissection reentry was the final successful strategy in 22% of the patients. The study was published simultaneously in JACC Interventions. Thank you.